Welcome you all for the technology upgrade meeting. Now I am going to discuss about the topic retinal imaging and image processing. I am Yuvraj J, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, Pratyusha Engineering College. Before move on to the topic, we'll know how the evolution has been done in optical industry and ophthalmology in image processing. Image processing is the technique where we are going to take the image and we are going to diagnose the disease. The disease is of various types in ophthalmology. For example, if you take the basic disease is going to be cataract, and when we are evolving diabetic retinopathy and then glaucoma, like lots of diseases due to aging, some macular disease will come. In that way, the retinal imaging and image processing is going to play a vital role in diagnosing the diseases. If you go for olden days, there was lots of invasive methods which is evolving to identify and diagnose a disease. In that way, the first method in 1960s created with Charles Babbage was ophthalmoscope technology and then tonometer technology to identify eye pressure. The tonometer technology was used at first. The tonometer technology is that where the pen-like structure is going to be there. That pen-like structure is going to be pressed into the eye and they are going to find the eye pressure. After that, after a great research has been happened in the ophthalmic industry, in that industry level, where the retina is going to contribute the major part of the eye, where it is going to be connected to the central nervous system, where it is going to have a double blood vessels in the eye. So that the research has been made to avoid an invasive method, and the research has been created for non-invasive method of diagnosing the diseases. In that way, we are going to find how the retinal structure is going to be using non-invasive method. The tonometer technology has been erased and abolished by fundus images. The fundus images technologies where the eye imaging is going to be like this. In this way, the eye image is going to contribute. In that, the doctors and medical practitioners are easy to identify how the nerve system has been moved. Using this nerve movement, the diseases can be identified. After that, this is going to be called as a tonometer technology. In that way, they are going to press the eye. After pressing that, they are going to identify the pressure. These are all the different modalities of retinal imaging, where one thing is going to be ultrasound. In that ultrasound, we are having A scan and B scan, then fundus fluorescent angiography, then OCT, then scanning laser ophthalmoscopy, retinal thickness analyzer, fundus autofluorescence. In that retinal thickness, once we are identifying the retinal thickness, we are going to know about lots of diseases in the eye environment. If you go for ultrasound imaging, this is going to be the process behind ultrasound imaging, where the patient has to lie down in the bed and they are going to have a pen-like structure. That structure is going to be pressed into the eye so that the pressure can be identified. Why the pressure has to be identified in the eye? In the sense that where when pressure increases in the eye, it will cause the blindness. The disease name is called as glaucoma. It is a very serious disease which is going to cause a blindness. When you are losing the vision due to glaucoma, it is lost. We cannot recover that vision at any point of view. Okay. Then the next existence of the evolution of eye imaging is going to be fundus photography. In this fundus photography, the images are going to be like this. Here, the nerve movement can be easily identified by the medical practitioners so that they can easily identify the diseases. At present, the research has been made for easiness of the patients and to save the time. It is going to be a time consumption process. This is going to be called optical coherence tomography, where it is going to be a multi-dimensional view of the eye is going to be taken as a picture. In that multi-dimension, we are going to view a 16 different layers of the eye. The main layer is going to be retinal nerve fiber layer. Using that retinal nerve fiber layer, we are going to easily identify the glaucoma or diabetic retinopathy or cataract or anything. Especially this OCT has been created only to identify the glaucoma disease, since it is going to be a very serious disease which is going to cause a blindness in the human eye. There are number of anatomical structures contribute to the process of vision. This presentation focuses on retinal imaging and how the image has been analyzed. These are all the different causes of blindness, where diabetic retinopathy and age-related macular degeneration, glaucoma, other retinal vascular disorders, myopic degeneration. Because of dysfunction in the retina, lots of diseases can be created, like we saw in the past, where the ophthalmic imaging is coming into the picture and it is having wide range of researches are going on in this optical imaging. In this optical imaging, the Zeiss, the company named Zeiss, were having a more researches in those things, where this is going to be the history of retinal imaging. First, Jan Pukne were created a tonometer technology, then Charles Babbage created ophthalmoscope, then fundus camera by Goldstrand, and then stereo fundus cameras, then it is optical coherence tomography. Current status of retinal imaging is, at present, the medical practitioner are using fundus imaging, OCT imaging, and then the advancement in OCT imaging is ultra wide field OCT, where we spoke about a fundus imaging. That fundus imaging is going to create a two-dimensional view of the eye, where the outer part of the eye can be viewed and the movements of the nerves can be easily identified. Using that nerve movement, the medical practitioner or doctor is going to identify the disease which affected to the human being. The technology is continuously in advancements. Technology is always advancing. We have to adapt to the technology, and we are into the research about optical imaging. Thank you for patient listening. Happy learning. Thank you.